Hello there, good morning. Joining us today from Anglo Pacific is Julian Treger here to discuss your fourth quarter results, which have just been published. We're going to go through some of the details now with you, Julian. Always great to see you. So, strong dividend reported for shareholders. We're also going to discuss how your portfolio in general has performed in this context of unprecedented turmoil for everybody involved. Maybe talk us through some of these points, Julian, and really how you feel the year has panned out.
Well, it was, you know, not the year that we all expected. Certainly the overall result was much lower than we had hoped. But what we did see, the beginnings of a very good rebound, particularly in the fourth quarter. The fourth quarter was much stronger than the third quarter, and almost at the same level of the fourth quarter in 2019, which was encouraging. So we did see, both copper and iron ore in particular recover sharply in the fourth quarter, and that's continued through so far, and that's been supplemented by coking coal, our biggest earner, being one of the best performers this year. So we're feeling better, certainly, about this year than we did about last year. Mm-hmm. That's the business. Our mines were shut down because of COVID, but there was less production. And obviously, there was a moment when everybody thought the world was stopping and commodity prices fell. Mm-hmm. Now, in fact, they're rebounding and the mood has really changed much more favorably towards our sector.
Mm-hmm. In the past, I know you've highlighted your solid income yield and returning capital to shareholders, something that is a sacrosanct to what you do. On top of the dividend, also share buyback program as well that's been going on. Can you maybe talk us through how that went and why you did it as well, Julian, crucially?
Well, we did it because our shares got to a ridiculously low level in our view. Mm-hmm. And we felt that we behoved the shareholders to make an investment in the shares. We bought back quite a lot of shares, at a low price, much lower than the current share price. But we also stimulated a lot of liquidity, and around 10% of the share capital changed hands, which I think is also helpful and gives a better base now for the stock to recover. But the stock is trading today at, 125, 130 with a 9% yield, a 9% dividend. The yield is really high. On top of that, we've returned the equivalent of 3p a share to shareholders by way of a buyback. So we have rewarded them in this difficult time. The number of retail shareholders encouragingly went up quite a lot last year. Mm-hmm. So I think the man in the street has really latched on to the fact that Anglo Pacific is a good income stock. We'll see how this year pans out.
Yeah, absolutely. In terms of Labrador Iron Ore Royalty Corporation, it looks like it's been a standout performer for you. I'll let you explain how so. Can you explain the strategy for this investment and maybe talk us through the rationale for the sale as well?
Well, we bought this investment roughly 2 years ago when the iron ore price was much lower than today. Mm-hmm. We bought it because it gives exposure to high quality iron ore in Canada, which we think is environmentally interesting, has a good carbon footprint. And also because we felt that iron ore was undervalued. And since then, on a combination of dividends, which they've paid, as well as capital appreciation, we've made roughly 60% on our investment. Mm-hmm. Now the iron ore price is roughly three times higher than the long-term consensus pricing for iron ore. So we felt it was appropriate to strengthen our balance sheet, take some money off the table. We retain roughly a $30 to $40 million stake in Labrador Iron Ore, the vast majority is profit. So we're running our profit, and we have the option to buy back into the stock should the price go down if iron ore prices drop. In the meantime, we have a balance sheet which has got net cash and is well positioned to finally execute on transactions which switch us into these battery metals and 21st century materials.
And something we've spoken about before in the past is your investment into Brazilian nickel and why you felt it was the right time to do that in sort of the coming years and how you might sort of reap the benefits to come. Maybe talk us through your wider strategy on this and in terms of your approach to commodities in this regard.
Well, I think we are in this transition from, you know, more bulk materials. Our coal heritage, our coal proportion has dropped hugely over the past couple of years under my stewardship. And obviously now selling a big portion of iron ore at the top of the market also reduces our exposure to iron making. And we are in this transition towards nickel, vanadium, copper, which we have exposure to, all the materials which we think are going to be more exciting commodities as people transition to a low carbon economy. And that also enhances our ESG profile. So that's definitely the direction we're shifting in. And we expect to see further progress on that in the months ahead.
And of course, that will be a key theme in 2021 for you. But in terms of other expectations in the mining and commodity sectors, what can we expect in terms of potential opportunities?
Well, we think that as the mining sector becomes more interesting, and that does seem to be the case for the last, you know, 3-6 months, people are understanding that post-COVID, the world is going to be a cleaner, greener place, and that requires a lot of these commodities in greater volumes. They haven't been produced, they haven't been invested in, and there's going to be shortfalls. There will be more demand for fundraisings, for capital, and that's exactly our sweet spot. You know, last year, I think a lot of the precious royalty companies, the gold and silver companies, did particularly well. Because there was a lot of uncertainty. You know, we think that now it's the turn for the non-precious players, and we're one of the biggest in the world. So that's quite an exciting position to be in.
Good stuff, Julian. Always a pleasure. Thank you so much indeed. That's Julian Treger there from Anglo Pacific here on Proactive London.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having me.